Hello, I'm Michelle Lovegrove. The federal government has defended docking parents their Centrelink money if they're not sending their children to school. The government says it's not a knee-jerk reaction, but a long-term solution. The Indigenous Affairs Minister has been touring remote Aboriginal communities in the South Australian outback for the past week. On his last day in the APY lands, Nigel Scullion says he's found at least one beacon of light. Political reporter Miles Morgan has been following the minister.
The students are having their breakfast at school in the small community of Indulkana. After breakfast, they brush their teeth and go to class.
This school will compare to any school in Australia. Any school in Australia. So for me, this is a new benchmark.
Attendance rates at this school are at nearly 90%, so there are still some students missing.
Aaron Vincent, if you fellas aren't here at school, you can't play football.
The Indigenous Affairs Minister wants to see the community, so he's guided around by the children and the elders. They've got ideas on how to improve education here, but so does Nigel Scullion. The federal government will start docking parents some of their welfare money if they don't send their kids to school.
Then you've got to get their attention. And my idea isn't sanctioning isn't the issue. I'm not motivated by wanting to sanction people. I'm motivated by wanting to actually talk to them about their responsibilities.
The new truancy measures will be rolled out across the APY lands. Nigel Scullion says some parents in the lands don't seem interested in an education for their children.
You know, just doing their thing rather than what the remainder of the community are doing, which is getting engaged in employment, the process of normalisation, I suppose.
While the rest of Indulkana may not be getting the same scrutiny as the school, the government says it's education, which is the most important thing in the APY lands. Miles Morgan, NITV News, Indulkana.